the stubbornness of my family, we're not going to stop until it's done. If it takes one session or 10 sessions, we won't stop. There will be a law.
Their daughter was kidnapped and killed 2 months ago. Now their fury turns into a fight to keep repeat predators off the streets. Tonight we've learned they're already meeting with lawmakers to start gathering support. Before Michael Klunder kidnapped Kathleen Shepherd and Desi Hughes in Dayton on May 20th, he had been convicted in 3 kidnappings.
And we are learning more tonight about an unusual twist in the cases that kept him from being locked up longer. Emily Price investigates what happened.
It is on this stretch of Highway 18, right on the Floyd County-Cerro Gordo County line, that Michael Klunder found one of his first kidnapping victims. It was December 15, 1991. A 21-year-old woman named Lori was driving alone.
Mr. Klunder apparently flagged her over and said she had some sort of equipment violation. I believe she got out of the car to check it out, and then he grabbed her, concealed her in his car. But fairly quickly, before he could do whatever he planned to do, she was able to get away. In that process, he assaulted her, and she was able to flag down someone. And my understanding is then he took off, and I think that's when he ended up in Texas.
Just from how he was with me, he seemed like a very angry person. And I guess I'd just a monster.
Law enforcement eventually caught up to him. They charged him with third-degree kidnapping and assault.
I was in the office at the time the Klunder case was prosecuted.
Cerro Gordo Assistant County Attorney Steve Tynan did not prosecute Klunder's specific case, but remembers plenty of conversations about it. He remembers well the disappointment of not being able to charge him with first-degree kidnapping so that they could put him away for life.
We didn't even have probable cause to argue that they were serious injuries.
The 21-year-old victim on Highway 18 did not have horrible physical injuries.
Her injury, I think maybe a few scratches or something like that.
Obviously a good thing, but it also meant Klunder only faced third-degree kidnapping and 10 years in prison instead of first-degree kidnapping and the rest of his life behind bars. That wasn't the only disappointment for prosecutors. Documents show the jury in this case had the option of finding Klunder guilty of third-degree kidnapping with the intent to commit sexual abuse or the lesser charge of kidnapping with assault causing bodily injury. The jury chose the lesser charge, saying there was no sexual link to the crime.
He grabbed her, he pulled her in the car, he must have had something in mind, and then he assaulted her. I don't want to say anything to criticize the jury. The jury did their job. It was a little frustrating, though.
Also a little frustrating, a few months after this court case, Klunder reached a plea deal on the kidnapping of 2 3-year-old girls. For all 3 kidnappings, he'd be sentenced to 41 years in prison, but served just 18 due to good behavior. The outcomes of the 2 cases ended up coming into play when Klunder was released from prison in 2011. There is something called the state's multidisciplinary team that could have decided to send Klunder to this high-security treatment facility in Cherokee that's strictly for sex offenders at highest risk of reoffending. But because there was no sexual crime, Klunder was released from prison with no restrictions, and 2 years later lured Kathleen Shepherd and Desi Hughes into his truck. Hughes was able to escape. Shepherd's body was found 18 days later in the Des Moines River.
If we can help protect just one child in Iowa or the nation, then this tragedy, as bad as it was, can mean something.
Kathleen's family is now fighting for tougher laws on kidnappers and anyone charged with crimes against children. They feel like the system failed her, and even seasoned prosecutors can't help but think that something needs to improve.
Looking back, yeah, I thought that we did what we could.
Specifically, Attorney Tynan would like to see a law enacted that if a child is kidnapped, that is purely enough to raise it to first-degree kidnapping and life in prison. Right now, that child would have to be seriously injured in the process to raise it to first-degree kidnapping and life in prison.
So, Emily, why was Klunder on the sex offender registry when the jury found him guilty of kidnapping but not with intent to commit sexual abuse?
That is another weird twist in all of this. Even though the jury said there was no sexual link to the crimes, the investigators who operate the state's sex offender registry can actually take a look at a conviction that happened before it became law, the sex offender registry law in 2009, look at all the evidence evidence that comes with that case and decide that there is, in fact, sexual motivation in that case, even though a jury has already said that they don't believe there is a sexual link.
Incredible. If Klunder had gone to Cherokee, what kind of treatment might he have received there?
He would have faced some intense treatment there until a psychiatrist. He would have been there until a psychiatrist, rather, with a whole combination series of tests confirmed he was safe enough to be back out into society. The stay would have been indefinite. Most people don't even get out of Cherokee. Tomorrow night at 10, we'll give you an exclusive look and show you what it's like there, how much it costs taxpayers, and how it's keeping our kids safe.
All right. Emily, thank you.